is very fast, quick workout before we get on the plane. So, but that's still a lot of work to do, just not much physical, a lot of it's mental. So we're obviously going to play a great team, and when you go and play teams like that, you got to do everything to give yourself a chance to win. And we coach as two players.
You said Sunday you think you had an idea of who would start the quarterback Saturday. Have you decided?
No, we've not. You know, like I said before, I have a pretty good idea of and definitely can see multiple guys playing, so we'll see.
Do you have a certain time when you'd like to tell the starting quarterback, whoever that may be, that they're going to be the starter on Saturday? Or?
I think they have a good idea, you know, just based off of reps. But, you know, we tell them all to be ready to play, and you all may play. So, you know, one of you's going to be first, and one of you's going to be second.
Lane, this is the first time as a head coach you've had experience games like this where you come in and they're games have to be scheduled because of, you know, guaranteed money and all that, and makes it difficult to win on the road against teams like that. So when you looked at that, when you first came here, how did you approach and what did you think of having to do with those types of games on the schedule?
That's a good question, and I thought a lot about that. You know, I had never been on the other side of these, you know, where obviously you're the, you know, major underdog, and, you know, your players don't look like their players. You know, we've always been on the other side. So, you know, the goal of the game is always to win. But I think now after being in some of these, you know, the goal is to win. Number one is to win. But, you know, I've got to do what I can control. And, you know, if you play really well and you manage the situations really well and the team seems ready to play, like I think, you know, for a good part of the Wisconsin game we were, you know, when we played in that game, we were a few plays away from, you know, that game, you know, having a chance to win it. So you feel better about that than you do a year ago to Oklahoma, where you say, okay, hey, obviously we weren't ready to play. You know, we lost by whatever, 40 points or something. So that goes on me. You know, we get a kick block. You know, we don't look like we're playing very well. You know, the number one goal is to win, but probably the number two is to, when you look, you say, okay, we're playing really well. There's plays we can't make. They make, you know, at times because they got better players, you know, on a, you know, certain plays. But so I think I look at it a little bit different now. But again, still goals to go up there and win. But got to just make sure that focusing on almost kind of grading yourself as the head coach, you know, how well do you manage all the situations and how well do you have them prepared and do you have the legs back, all the things you worry about in a normal world for two.
The stuff you have to leave, you can't worry about budgets and how much money they need for that. But can they, regardless of the outcome, can they be beneficial in two? Number one, the experience a lot of these kids get that haven't played in stadiums like this. And number two, can it be beneficial losing a game, playing a team like this, even if you lose? How much benefit can some of these kids get out of this?
Well, I think that depends on how the game goes. I think, you know, there's an experience factor. Just, hey, they get to go play there. So their whole life, they say, I played at Ohio State. Okay, so whatever that is. So, but I think that there is, if you play them really well, you know, obviously if you win, or if you play close where you play them really well, I'm sure that builds kids' confidence. You know, they say, hey, I got, you know, go play against that guy, or, you know, I'm the left tackle, I'm blocking, you know, the first pick of the draft, you know, that they're saying the guy is. So, you know, I'm a receiver and I'm running routes and getting open versus a corner that's, you know, slotted to go in the top 15 picks. So I think there'd be something to that.
And lastly, when you're on the other side, it's probably a bad choice of word, but you ever feel bad for that opponent? You know, and I know coaches don't feel bad for other coaches and other coaches, but do you ever look across that side and say, you know, like, they had to come here, they had to come to Alabama, we know in this game. You must have a different feeling for that opponent than you do when you play Auburn.
Well, I didn't at the time. I didn't ever feel bad for them when we were playing those. Now I have a different view, so I think everybody should. It's like I said before, my path didn't go the normal way. Normally you were at a place like this where you played those games, you know, as a younger coach. And so I think I have a different appreciation now where, you know, maybe I would manage those games different in the fourth quarter, you know, than I did back then.
What Ray Ellis has done this offseason, even going back to spring camp, has he earned a starting spot?
He's right there. I think Saturday he'll start in some of our packages. Says a lot for the kid to go through all those surgeries and keep coming back and could have not even played this year like a lot of kids would have and just hung it up. So it says a lot about the kid.
What are your thoughts on starting the season against such a tough opponent like Ohio State? Like, you know, some pro programs choose to have maybe more of like a easier opponent, not have to deal with such a top five opponent such as Ohio State. What are your thoughts on, you know, that type of scheduling?
I've got a lot of that questions that week or this week about that. And I think it depends where your program is. You know, if you're at this level, let's say you're UCF and okay, hey, you've established yourself for years of playing really good, and you know, you look at it and say, hey, we need one of those, you know, to get us into, you know, the playoffs if we go undefeated, because if we go undefeated, otherwise we're not going to get in. Well, that's different. You know, if you're at this level and you haven't been established for years to where you built up your roster to, you know, be a top 20 team, you know, I think it's different. But everyone has their different methods, and this game was scheduled before we got here, you know, by the last AD, because he was from there, so is what it is. I wouldn't do it because you can get the same amount of money going to play teams in those conferences that aren't the elite team in the conference. You know, that, you know, obviously it stacks up a little more in your favor.
You've talked about your concerns with the receivers. Last year you had Noah Jefferson midway through the year because he was eligible and he wound up playing. Do you guys have the space to maybe do something like that at receiver?
We do. We have a little bit of space from you know, some guys that were going to come but didn't make it, and so they don't count, or were here but didn't left. So we've added DeAndre McNeil back. He's working out with us for the last couple of days. He's just not out there at practice. You know, we'll start him in practice next week. Just didn't think it was right to throw him right in practice with the guys. And so we're doing all his work on the side.
Receiver, I know he's playing defensive end at SMU. Receiver?
Yeah. I mean, that's obviously where, you know, we need help. We've discussed that before, especially on the outside. And so to add him back was basically free for us because you don't get, they don't count twice once they leave your program. So it was kind of an easy choice for us because there's no risk for us. We don't lose a spot, and he already knows the offense.
How does that work? How does that not count as a transfer if he'd already been with another team?
Because once you sign him, and once you sign them to an NLI, when they leave and they come back, they don't count again. So when the kid, you know, like Adrian Bryant, whether he went somewhere or not, he was gone and he came back and he doesn't count again, which was part of taking him back.
Does that include even if he had played in the game? Do you know?
I think it does, because I think the when you bring back a kid, even when they go to a JC, I don't think they count. So even when they go play and come back.
When you play against these high-profile teams, Ohio State, UCF, and you know that you've got guys on your team that are potential next-level players, do you feel a responsibility at all to ensure that they get to showcase themselves against some of these better teams to give kind of scouts a real good look at what they can do? Does that ever enter? What do you think?
No. You mean make sure you schedule these type of games so they...
No, make sure once you're playing these games that you have... You know, X amount of times you try to get this person the ball so that he can show what he can do on offense. Or, I mean, I know he's probably one of your better guys anyway, so you're going to try and do that.
But like you said, that's going to happen anyway because he's that NFL guy, one of your better guys anyway. But, you know, we wouldn't ever game plan to feature people based off of their draft status or matchups. You know, we do the best thing to win.
You mentioned the potential number one pick in Chase Young, and obviously FAU hasn't had to face an opponent with that kind of stature before. I mean, he's probably going to be the best edge rusher coming out of the class. Is there any thoughts about just kind of having to face him, knowing that he could potentially just terrorize your offense the whole game?
Yeah, that was really made me feel good about the matchup. Terrorize. Obviously, you got a game plan for a guy like that. You got a game plan for him even if you're at Alabama and you're playing him, you know, like playing Myles Garrett. So you got a game plan for him because, as you said, especially on the road in a loud place, he can wreck your game plan. And the other end's really good, too.
Go ahead.
DeAndre, I want to get just some on DeAndre. He was here, started hot, disappeared for 2 years, left school. He's back now late. Other than it doesn't cost you anything, what makes you think that he can make an impact positively with you guys?
Like I said, it's no risk. It's like signing a free agent in the NFL to no guaranteed money. Like, you know, at that level, you just cut him, and so you just don't play him. So, and I discussed this with the players' leadership group and left it up to them. And, you know, they said, hey, let him come back because, you know, even though he left, hey, if the guy can help us win, that's our number one priority. So I wouldn't have done it if I left it up to them.
I know that this is kind of looking ahead. I know you're worried about Ohio State right now, but with Tropical Storm Dorian kind of looming inside the Atlantic, have you talked to the players about kind of what's the plan going ahead or not yet so far?
Yeah, our administration's meeting today on potential scenarios, you know, from not playing to going up there and staying like we did before. So I don't know anything about weather, but what they tell me is, you know, there's different opinions of what's going to happen. So we can't make any decisions right now on it. But they're planning to obviously have all the things ready from, you know, the plane being delayed and staying up there and hotels and all that. And so whatever they say to do.
At least you know to protect the boat this time.
I know, I just actually told someone to get the insurance thing because I didn't have insurance last time. I do have to read what it says, whether to take it out. Someone said you need to take the boat out. And I said, well, what's the point of paying for insurance? I pay for insurance now. Why do I need to go pay to take the boat out? I have someone reading that today to tell me more about that.
Thanks, Coach.